Very good morning to all of you. First of all, I would be presenting a lecture on role of flexible FAC devices in conventional power systems. Now, I think that a lot of work has been shown already to you people in FAC side. So I'll be mainly concentrating on machines part at the last session. And I'll be taking one controller, and then I'll be enhancing the performance of controller with some auxiliary signal, right? So starting will be from some very basic fundamentals. After that, I'll be taking STATCOM, elaboration of STATCOM, and some parts time to time I'll be taking in electrical machines. And at last, I'll be taking electrical machines part, because whenever we are talking about power system is nothing. It is induction motors load, then static loads, then we are talking about synchronous condensers, then we are talking about generators. So most of the generation is being done by the generators. Most of the load, dynamic load, is in induction motor side. So that part I'll be taking later on. So first of all, I'm starting from basics of FACs and some very basic fundamentals of electrical engineering. So for this, prerequisite is you have very good and sound knowledge in electrical machines, particularly dynamic analysis of electrical machine. So whenever we are talking about dynamic analysis, that means whatsoever we have studied in undergraduate level, so that was only phasors. Phasors means we are neglecting the time. So when we are actually implementing the machine, that is in real time, and we'll have to see all the parameters including time. That means whenever load will be changed, how dynamics will be changed, how movement of inertia is adverse or giving adverse effect to our system, that then you can see stability problem is coming. So coming back onto the topic, then power systems. So very basic fundamental is known to you. I think it's very common thing that in resistance, voltage and current are in phase. In inductance, voltage leads the current. That is very important. Capacitor, voltage lags the current. Now, if you are looking onto the complete scenario of electrical engineering, whether it is electrical machines, whether it is power systems, whether it is FAC devices, the difference between real system and FAC system is actually we are generating the virtual resistance, virtual inductance, and virtual capacitance. This is the only difference. And in conventional systems, we use the actual resistance, we use actual inductance, we use actual capacitance. So this is how FAC devices are working. So next is, if I'm taking the conventional power system, I'm talking about 1950s or 60s. Say, this is a transmission line. This is a generator. And over here, there's a load. Now, I'm taking only two cases. When load will be increased or decreased, and when a fault will be there on a transmission line or on a power system. So case A is, say the voltage or the load has been decreased due to any reason, open circuit is there, say Ferranti effect, that is called Ferranti effect. Ferranti effect is nothing, we are, or power system is taking it as some capacitance has been introduced into the path. So what will be there, that voltage will be increasing, right? And sometimes load will be increased. Say general power factor load is 0.8 pf lag. That means some inductance is there. And during a short circuit, what will be there? The total circuit will be working as purely inductive load. And this all has to be done in a fraction of a second. Now you see the problem that if there is a fault at this transmission line and it has to travel onto the generator with a velocity of light, it is going on to excitation system if it is active power, reactive power. If it is active power, then we'll have to control the frequency. Now just see that this signal has to be moved. If I'm talking about frequency control, then various governors will be there, amplification time will be there, and lot of time constants with different machines or with different components will be there. So up to the time we are clearing the fault, it may be there that some of the component may be lost if circuit breaker is not working properly. If I am taking the case of load change, drastic load change, if it is gradual, there is no problem in that case. But if there is any sudden load change, that is again some minimum effect of this load onto the power system. So what is happening in first case, if I'm talking about from this side, excitation system and frequency control, that means excitation system, we are controlling the voltage and ultimately we are changing the reactive power. If I'm talking about frequency conventionally, then we can say it is active power. So as I have explained earlier, there is surge impedance loading. So whenever we'll have to compare anything, we'll have to take some reference. So in this case, this reference is surge impedance loading. If the value of capacitor or no load or capacitive effect is more than this, then voltage profile is increasing. On the another side, if the inductor has been incorporated, the voltage is reducing. That means voltage profile is increasing. Now you see any system, if I'm talking about transformers, if I'm talking about any winding in any machine, voltage regulation is counted to be a very important fundamental. That means no load to full load change should be minimum. That is first requirement. So whenever there is a short circuit, you see that earlier before short circuit, it was 500 kilovolts. And when short circuit has worked properly, what is happening? The voltage has been reduced to zero. Now this load change cannot be accepted by any system, whether it is any, you can say general case if we are taking, or if we are taking power systems, this much load change cannot be accepted by any system. So conventional schemes have given, at the last slide, I'll be showing you the comparison also, how we can compare different FACT devices with this particular part. The next slide is short circuit. I think this is visible to you people. So what is happening? I have taken a short circuit. This part is short circuit current in kiloamperes, and lower part is whenever a short circuit has been incorporated into the system, the voltage has been reduced to zero. This is only to show you. Now, if you look on to this slide, what does it shows? At no load, inductive capacitive effect. That means if by any means during no load we give inductive effect, if capacitive is there, give inductive. If inductive load is there, give capacitive. So that is how facts are working. So what is there? If you are looking onto the previous PVT, if no load is there, capacitive effect or Ferranti effect is there, we'll have to give inductive effect or we'll have to give inductance. If surge impedance is loading is there, no need. You need not to give any kind of compensation. Then rated load is there or short circuit is there, we are moving into the inductive region. So in inductive, we'll have to give capacitive. Now this is how FACT devices are working. So we are basically working on to this type of compensation. Now I'll be taking first, say how FACT devices has been evolved into the system. I can categorize first generation of FACT devices, then new FACT devices. Between them, there is one very important component in electrical machines will be there. I'll be showing you. So over here, what is there? First of all, thyristor controlled reactor. This is nothing. This is, we are changing the reactance. If this capacitive effect is increasing or decreasing, inductive has to be increased or decreased. That means this change has to be incorporated with TCR. The problem with TCR is thyristor controlled reactor is it is working onto capacity part only. Then further amendment, I have incorporated fixed capacitor as well as TCR. The problem with this is that it can give only fixed capacitance. We cannot change it. So that has been replaced with mechanically switched capacitor. In that case, the problem is mechanical part and we are not using the thyristor part. The switching operations are very much limited. So life cycle is the main problem for fixed capacitor or you can say mechanical switch capacitor. After 2000 operations to 5000 operations, it used to fail. After that, the new incorporation was TSC and TCR. So if you are looking on to this SVC, I'm not explaining all the parts. I'm taking only the last part, that is TSC and TCR. This is called SVC also. So over here, this is the power system. This is a transformer. And over here, we have incorporated TCR as well as TSC. I'm not taking the controlling part at this moment. I'll be taking only in STATCOM, and with the help of that STATCOM controller will be, because that is the advanced version, that can be incorporated in SQC. The same fundamentals can be incorporated in SVC. The same fundamentals can be included into UPFC. And if we are looking on to the complete VI characteristics of TSC and TCR, now what is there? Actually, this part is inductive and this is part is being taken care by TCR, thyristorized controlled reactor. And this part may be taken by fixed capacitor if it is fixed. If it is a mechanically switched capacitor or thyristor switched capacitor, the characteristics may change downward or upward, right? So the problem is the working area for this SVC is that up to this region, from here V max to V min to this V reference, this is approximately 0.03 plus minus 0.03%, and that is a very small range. So there is a problem. Say there is a fault. So what will happen? This V reference will automatically reduce to zero value. V reference, because short circuit voltage will become equal to zero. From one per unit, it is going to zero. That is a drastic change. So in this region, this particular region, the TCR as well as TSC combination fails. It works only for this reason. So what is there? This I have already explained. Now this part has to be replaced, or this is a replacement to the STATCOM. So we can move on to TSC to TCR and then to STATCOM. So as I have told you that nowadays we are not using. So there are different problems in power system. These are a very basic problem I have discussed. So whenever we'll talking about power system, it's a very complicated system. So voltage, you can say faults are the minimum cases. So the basic problems are subsynchronous resonance as well as slow response time. So I'll be taking in the next slide subsynchronous resonance. Before that, I'm taking the different components. What I have explained over here, SVC we have seen. SVC means TSC and TCR. It is not working on the full range, and we are saying that we'll have to incorporate the new FET devices. Before that, these components are basically your thyristorized controlled equipments, but this is your conventional FET devices. This is conventional FET device. So what is there? Whenever you are putting a synchronous machine as a compensator, it is running on no load. And whenever requirement of reactive current is there, if it is the system is the system is lagging, or you can say the system voltage has been increased. So that increase can be reduced with the help of synchronous compensator. And if there is any inductive load, then what this synchronous condenser will doing, it will be increasing the level of the voltage. But the problem with this is its response time is very slow because of movement of inertia. So although it is working very well, but in some times when a very heavy short circuit there on the generator terminal, this is not working. So we can say this is the major disadvantage. Moreover, the cost of the synchronous compensator is up to some extent, it's very high. But when we are talking about performance of electrical quantities, cost doesn't matter. So there are some advantages of new FACT devices. So in these new FACT devices, I'll be taking STATCOM. In STATCOM, I'll be taking voltage regulation first of all. How voltage can be regulated with the help of controllers. I think a lot of work has been done on how STATCOM is working and all that, but controller part I'll be going to explain. So the voltage controller of STATCOM cannot be worked onto this SSR problem. That means we'll have to add some supplementary signal or auxiliary to the conventional controller. And that advanced controller, that is conventional plus auxiliary controller, can control the SSR. SSR is sub-synchronous resonance. So first of all, STATCOM, then voltage regulation, then SSR. So this part I think already has been taken care. I'm taking a very small brief overview of the STATCOM in context with main circuit. And next part will be your controlling circuit. So in main control circuit, what is there? If this power system voltage is more, this generated voltage by the STATCOM is less. So what does mean? Whenever flow of voltage or flow of power will be from higher potential to lower potential. So the power will flow from power system to this STATCOM. Then this STATCOM has to sense that voltage has been reduced. It has to generate reactive power opposite to that. That means the STATCOM should work as a capacitor opposite to that. And over here, there is some concept I'll be showing you in the this particular part, that how this reactive current is behaving and how we can see the behavior of reactive current in this particular part. In this case, reactive current should lead the system voltage V1. Opposite to that, if V1 is greater, if this part is, I think this is less. If this is less, then it must absorb. Opposite to that, inductive, and this voltage leads. If these two voltages are equal, that means reactive power cannot flow in any direction, the STATCOM will be working into floating mode. Neither it is taking the power, nor it is giving the power. This is the control circuit. Now over here, you will have to concentrate. This part is voltage V1, power system voltage. This is STATCOM, and we'll have to take the output from this voltage as well as current flowing from this side, this power system. That can be done with the help of this controller. Now what is there? V1 is the system voltage, IS is the total power system current, V reference, it is very well known to us that V reference must be equal to 1 per unit always, and there is one system voltage. Actually, this line is common. V1, V1, and over here V1. So V1, this V1, and V1. This is common. This is IS. IS is the input current to the STATCOM. So what will be there? IS is over here. So we'll have to apply one measurement unit for this particular part. this particular part and this particular part. Over here, there is a main problem that your AC current is three phase in nature and we are using D and Q component. I'm repeating that this is very important part. This is voltage, and this is voltage. This voltage is in ABC, that means three variables are there. But when we are working on to controller, we'll have to convert into D and Q axis from machine's part. As I have explained earlier, these FET devices has to work onto machines. Machines are actually three phase circuit, say a three phase induction machine, three phase synchronous machine is there. And those machines are working in three phase system, IA, IB and IC. So what will be there? Total six governing equations will be there. That means we'll have to apply six different equipments. And you see that cost doesn't matter. Here the problem is, instead of three, if you are using two converters or two values you will have to change, it is rather easy. The system becomes very easier. That is why here we'll have to give one measurement unit. And from this measurement unit, what we are doing, we are taking the positive sequence component, negative sequence component, and we are giving it to this PLL. This PLL is doing nothing. What we are seeing, that voltage is there, this current is there, and there is some lag or lead is there. That lag or lead, if we are looking onto this slide, you see that some voltage is there. This is STATCOM voltage, this is STATCOM current. Now this lag or lead has to be measured, and that can be measured with the help of this PLL. That means we are getting theta out of it. Okay, so V reference one, this is measured value. So how it is working? This must be equal to one, and this voltage, say it reduces. This voltage has been reduced by some amount. So what will be there? Error will be produced. V reference minus V1, the voltage has been reduced. Right? Now up to this, system is working. Now this system is being captured by this PI regulator. This is PI regulator, voltage regulator. It is sensing the voltage. It is changing the voltage signal to IQ reference. Because you know that if the voltage is falling, that has to be captured, that has to be corrected. That correction is being done into this block. This is called PI voltage regulator. Number one. Number two, it is converting the main component, that is IQ. IQ component is responsible for reactive power, whereas IP or active power has to be controlled by this P component. So I'm taking, or in these particular cases, I have taken that reactive power, active power is zero, and there is total relationship of reactive power. That means we are working on to voltage signal. So this is IS. Again, here is some measurement unit. This measurement unit, number one, it is measuring the IA, IB and IC. This is converting into D and Q axis. Simplification, that means three phase to two phase, that means Parks transformation has been implemented over here, and this signal is going into this particular part. And you know that when two components are at 90 degree to each other, then you can say IQ square plus IP square under the root. If we are bifurcating that, we are taking only reactive power. So that is why I have shown over here only IQ is coming, although we have IP plus JIQ, but we are neglecting IP over here. So from here, measured value of IQ, from here, reference value of IP. Why it is reference? Because it has been corrected by the PI voltage regulator. So again, there is an error, IQ, reactive power. This is being given to the PI current regulator, and this angle is called gamma. So this gamma is being given to the VSC. I think this part has already been taken by my colleagues in the previous classes. I am not going to into the details of VSC. So what will be there? Gamma, 1 theta, and. Now you see that there is one VDC. This is capacitor actually. Now this can be a capacitor. This can be a energy storage device. What is the difference between this capacitor? Sometime we used to take energy storage device. Now you see that the behavior of capacitor, it is like a flywheel. It stores energy during positive half of the cycle and releases energy, instant energy release in negative half. The same work is being done in your bikes and even generators, flywheel. So what flywheel does, it takes positive energy during positive half and instantaneously release the energy during negative half. But when you are taking energy storage device, that energy storage device is not instantaneous. That is based upon energy, and this is based upon power. So whenever a short circuit is required, if you are feeding the short circuit in a very slow manner, till that period, the power system may burst. It's a fraction of a second that your power system may burst. So over here, we'll have to see that what kind of application is required. So if application is slow, we can take over here, what we can say, energy storage device. If application is instantaneous, like a short circuit is there, you have to apply capacitor. So this is based upon power density, and that energy storage device is based upon your energy storage device. So coming back onto the topic, we have used, because we are working onto this particular part, SSR, or what we can say about voltage regulation. So the response should be instantaneous. So we are using capacitor over here. So DC balance is there. We are getting DC from here, regulating it, and this part is being given to this. So this DC value is actually nothing. It is a small reactive power, active power, because you see that we are using transformers. We are playing with VSC. This is a transformer. We are playing with VSC. So when you are running this, there will be resistance as well as resistance will be there. So whenever this is switching, losses will be there. So whenever we are talking about losses, that means resistance. Resistance means there is no part of reactive power. So that is why we are playing with this VDC. It is giving you a small active power losses that can be compensated with DC part. So this part is taking care, what you can say, active power, small active power, which is required for working of this particular system. So three components has been matched over here. That is theta. This is again angle that has to be incorporated. Here is angle gamma, which is taking care of that your voltage slope. And this is your active power. So these three has to be added into the firing pulse generator. And this firing mixture of these has to be given over here. And at that time, this VSC, that is main circuit, is working. Correct? So this is called conventional power system. This is one scheme. If you are taking on, this is this, I have taken this VSC as GTO, STATCOM, or this is GTO based. So this firing scheme or this total control scheme is based upon GTO. We are controlling only angle alpha, or we can say theta plus gamma plus K in proportional relationships. This is another scheme, and I have not taken this scheme in this particular PPT. And after this, I'll be taking this part, I think, as we have already taken into the part, V reference is there. In SVC, this was going like this. And in this TCR, it is going like this. Now, what is happening in this case? Say a complete short circuit is there. the voltage will reduce up to, say, this level. Up to this level, the voltage 0.33 of per unit, say it is less than this. So what will be there? SVC fails because it is not independent with respect to voltage. But in this case, it is, if you extend this characteristics either on this side, if you extend this characteristics either on this side, so what will be there? It is able to capture this fault, right? It is able to capture this fault. So whenever we are here, no doubt we can move on to this characteristics, and this ultimately leads to this part. So this complete part, this as well as above part, can be taken care by the STATCOM in actual power system. Now I have taken two case studies. What we can conclude out of it, that for this part, it is giving, it is working for inductive. For this part, it is working for capacitive. So what I have taken, actual implementation, because we used to see many examples. So what we have taken over here, there is self-excited induction generator. For as in the previous section, ma'am has already discussed about hybrid compensation. So SEIG is taking huge reactive power during starting as well as any load change. It only gives active power, and the starting as well as some part of the reactive power has to be taken by this fixed part. If you are comparing these two, the cost of this variable device and the cost of this static device is very, you can say in comparison to this, this static device is very cheaper. So what we are doing, say I'm talking about in very simple terms, I'm requiring a requirement of 5 kVAr for the system. So what we used to do, we used to take the analysis. What is the minimum requirement? Say it is 3 kVAr. So what we used to do, that this 3 kVAr permanently, it has to be given by this. But whenever there is a load change, there is a short circuit, there is an increase in wind power, there is a decrease in wind power, any load change requires instantaneous reactive power. So that instantaneous plus or minus part has to be given by the STATCOM. And I have taken one load over here and one secondary load for controlling the active power. So I have taken only active power. Here some active power load is there. This is kilowatt. This is kilowatt. So what will be there? When I have taken two cases, when this STATCOM is not there and load has been changed or we have started the SEIG, you will be seeing that system collapse. Voltage regression. The voltage earlier, say it was at no load, it was 415, and we have applied some load, or say we have started it, it builds up, but after some time it reduces. So we can see it from here. What is there, that say I have not taken the STATCOM. Initially the SEIG has been started, voltage has been built up, and STATCOM is not there. Because of lack of reactive power, it goes to zero finally. And if you are applying a STATCOM, what will be there? The voltage is on 1 per unit. Fine. What is the simultaneous effects on the complete system? This SEIG, because it doesn't have the reactive power is there, and active power is there, but there is no load. So what will be there? This SEIG is going to unstable part. Whereas when we have applied STATCOM, this is more than 1 per unit, because this SEIG has to run on 1 PU speed, more than 1 PU, because there will be some losses. So in this case, I have taken 275 kVA generator SEIG, but it is giving 200 kilowatt active load. This is about SEIG. At the same time, what is happening with reactive power? Reactive power, if the system collapse. Initially, reactive power was around 70 kVAr, but after collapse, this has been reduced to zero. This is but obvious because system is not working, so reactive power should be equal to zero. And when this STATCOM has been applied, so what is there? This is initial part, this is the transient part, and within 1 second, this has been captured and it is giving a stable value. So just see, this is stable. Just see, this is again unstable. This is unstable. It is hampering the system. And this system is again constant reactive power requirement. Now, this is regarding or with this conventional controller. Now, there is one another big problem is there in SSR, that is called in power system, that is subsynchronous resonance. So first of all, we should try to understand that what do we understand by subsynchronous resonance. You see that actually we are working in electrical engineering. We cannot say that we'll have to work only with electrical engineering because the generator has to work with mechanical part also, because the generator has been linked or has to be coupled with the turbine. Turbine means it is a mechanical part. It has moment of inertia. So whenever moment of inertia comes into the picture, whenever you take any system, moment of inertia comes into picture, that means mechanical oscillations will be there. The another problem in electrical engineering is when you are taking RLC circuit, if it is series RLC circuit, that means R, L, and C, and when XL will be equal to XC, total, that means that is called series resonance. If it is in parallel, that will be called as parallel resonance. So when the mechanical oscillations of turbine and the electrical oscillations of the generator mix, there is no doubt every time it mixes, but when the total, that means mechanical frequency plus electrical frequency is 60 hertz. I have taken 60 hertz system, IEEE bench, so that is why I'm taking IEEE, so it is working on 60 hertz. So if the combination of mechanical oscillations plus electrical oscillations is equal to 60, that means that is a stage of subsynchronous resonance. How it's affecting the system? Actually, this resonance oscillations are going to the turbine. That turbine is coupled with low pressure turbine and high pressure turbine, so the torque will increase drastically. Otherwise, in normal system, the torque must be less than 1 per unit, but when resonance will be there, it is occurring or it is hampering the system, and ultimately it will break the shaft of the system. So due to this, there may be a complete blackout in total reason. So whenever we are going for planning of any system, we have to take this particular part into consideration. So I am taking first of all SSR, subsynchronous resonance. So what is there? There is a generator. This generator has been coupled with exciter, generator shaft coupling, low pressure turbine, high pressure turbine. This is a complete system. And this complete system, which is coupled, it's a very large shaft, and it has been coupled with generator. Now, this part, you can say this is this is a mechanical part of the generator. And beyond this, we are coming into this particular part. This is transformer, bus one, two transmission lines connected in parallel. Over here, there is a another bus, and this has been connected with some system to the infinite bus bar. Now what will happen? The electrical resonance is being created by this ZL1 with interacting with XC, which is variable in nature. So what will happen in this IEEE, this is IEEE standard test bench, when you create a fault, what will happen? This XL1 will become equal to XC when 55% compensation is there. So what you can see over here, this is a frequency graph, frequency phase frequency graph of this electrical system. You can see that this value is 33 hertz. That means FE from here, electrical part is giving 33 hertz. What is happening in this case with mechanical side? So I'm taking this turbine shaft, and you see, when this is 33, resonance has been occurred. This current is moving onto the ultimately rotor side of the generator, and rotor has been coupled with this because oscillations are there. These oscillations are coming onto this shaft. So this oscillation is minimum, and ultimately when coupling will be there, one coupling, second coupling, more problem, complex problem. And you see that the torque on these shafts must be one per unit, but it is extending up to 10 per unit. Now over here, this is not a simply graph. It is up to 1 second, or rather you can say within 1.1 second, these oscillations will be with the help of, or it is oscillating at 60 hertz. So these mechanical oscillations are at 27 hertz. So as I have told you earlier, when this mechanical oscillations will be equal to electrical oscillation, 27 plus 33, we are with subsynchronous resonance problem, and that will be breaking the shaft of the system, and your complete blackout will be there because main generator is not working. So what will be there? This is the clear part of the previous part. This is again. Now you can see the FFT analysis of this. I have taken at 0 to 0.1. This magnitude is approximately 3.9 over here. In 1 to 2 seconds, it is increasing. We can see it from here also. This is only to counter check that whether it is applicable or not. Then we can say this is increasing up to this limit. Now this is what is happening with that of complete power system if there is no compensation. So if we are applying only one STATCOM with conventional controller, which I have already implemented onto voltage regulator, what will be there? This oscillations are reducing. Just compare this. These oscillations are increasing, but these oscillations are constant. Now you see the magnitude, although these are constant, but the magnitude is 5 per unit. So you can take any system. If a system can take 1 PU, you are putting it 2 PU, the system will burst. So over here, it is up to peak oscillation is 4 to 4. So it is again breaking, it is not working. Partially working, but it is not working in a fuller way. So what is happening when you are applying this STATCOM with some auxiliary signal, and which is being captured from this rate of change of angular momentum? This has to be captured. This has to be given onto subsynchronous damping controller. I'm repeating, this part is subsynchronous damping controller. What it is doing actually, you see that these values are increasing. You incorporate some compensation that this increased part on positive, this increased part on negative should be cut it out. That is called in electrical, we used to say compensation. So this part is being done with the help of this SSDC. Now you see that electrical components doesn't understand mechanical language. So ultimately what we have done, we have converted the mechanical language into electrical language with the help of this SSDC as well as STATCOM. Now what is there in this SSDC? You see that this is again same, we are using the STATCOM as I have told you. From here, we used to capture delta omega, this is converting the delta omega into some signals that is called speed transducers. And these transducers are converting this angular speed into some signal, which can be filtered. Maximum limit can be given and minimum limit can be given onto this part. It will sense that whether the signal is for low pass filter, it is for medium band filter, or it is for high band filter. So this signal is coming from here, and onto this there is also a selector, so which is selecting that what kind of frequency it is. If the frequency is very low, which is normally electrodynamic behavior, so we can say we can use this or this. So whichsoever signal, say this signal has been picked up, say this signal has been picked up, or say this signal has been picked up. So this has been, say this signal has been picked up, again there is a saturation block, and this saturation block has been implemented onto the firing generator. This is onto the firing generator. So earlier what was there in voltage regulation? Only theta was there, gamma was there, and K was there. That means these two are taking care of reactive power, and this is taking small losses of active power, which is being consumed by this. But another auxiliary signal has been added onto the adder or summer of the STATCOM. That means this mechanical part and this total electrical part is being given to the VSC. Now you see the behavior of the system. You see that within 0.3 second, it's 0.7 second, the value is increasing, and this value is very small for a very small duration, and it is damping the signal. That means that increasing fashion has been reduced. Now in researcher language, we used to say that number one, you must take a standard system. On that you can apply any system. So all the work has been, actually if you are talking about MATLAB is nothing, it is a translator. If I want to make this, I can make this model by any means, by hook or by crook. But when you are making the system in what we can say in our technical language, we used to say jugaad, right? So whenever we are making some jugaad, so what will be there? You cannot apply anywhere. So whenever we are talking about IEEE bench, if you have made the MATLAB model in a correct way, and you should check it onto your IEEE system. So there are many systems. If you are taking faults, if you are taking any, you can say, optimization tool. So there are in standards, IEEE 5 bus system is there, IEEE 24 or 30, these systems are there. So whenever you are making any controller, when you are going for any optimization technique, so my request is please work hard onto that optimization tool and try to do the actual work and then implement onto the standard system. And if the results are fine, nobody can challenge, right? So over here, what is happening? This has been earlier time, what was there? This magnitude was increasing, and over here this magnitude is reducing. I think what is the time? Up to 1 o'clock. Okay, so this is a comparison of SVC. I think this is I need not to show all this because this already has been covered. Now if we are taking onto this static synchronous series compensator, again same thing is there. This reactive power is being imposed onto the system in series, right? And this is the control circuit. Same value will be there. We can capture the current from here. This is voltage V1. This voltage V1 is there at system voltage, we can say. V2 is the output of the SQC. And VDC, again, this VDC is, as I have discussed, this energy, this is energy storage device. It is taking care of the value of active power. So what will be there? This is measurement, voltage measurement, again, voltage measurement, DC measurement. These all are comprising of any measurement system. If measurement is not right, if your tool is not working well, you cannot implement. But you don't worry about that, because these have already been implemented in MATLAB, and these are the justified measurement units. Then these measurements are breaking up. Over here, this component has been made equal to zero. Only ID is there, right? So what will be there? From here, we can capture V1, we can capture V2. This signal has been compared, and this is ultimately going to VQ, as I have discussed earlier. This is V reference, VQ reference, you will have to define. Then this is VQ regulator, and you are getting VQ output. From here, as a discussion in earlier controller, this VDC was giving the active power for capacitor only. But in this case, it is actually contributing into the active and reactive power. So from here, this theta is nothing. As per our previous discussion, this PLL unit is converting some value. Voltage is there, and PLL is converting voltage and current angle. We are getting theta out of it. So theta can be incorporated over here. This can be incorporated over here, because we'll have to check every time what is the lag between V1 and V2. There must be some checking instrument every time. So this theta can be measured, and this theta can be implemented onto PWM modulator. In the previous case, it was only theta and two signals in terms of only capacitor voltage control was there. But over here, this can control active as well as reactive power. So these two parts can be taken care by a very simple technique, PWM modulator. So you can design your own modulators. This can be SPWM, space vector PWM modulator. You can take any kind of modulator. So from here, we are getting VSC pulses, and this is being given to this particular part. And next part, as Dr. Ritula has already taken, and I don't think that this is, I should explain it again, but the main component over here, VSC is there. We are taking real power from here, or we are taking any active or reactive power from here that can be fed to this VDC, and we can give it on to this particular part. Fine. So the main advantage is it is open. It can move here and there. That means very, you can say, dynamic control of voltage is there. If you really want to understand the concept of this, I think you should go for a phase shift transformer. Just see the phase shift transformer. That is this UPFC. Is nothing. It is a modern, you can say, UPFC. So if you implement that phase shift, or understand that phase shift transformer, you can see this part also. And at last, if you see the performance of various FACT devices, you will see if there is no FACT devices in 1950s, this was the fault clearing time. It was very less. It is around 7 cycles. The system can capture, system can sustain up to 7 cycles. Then if we are applying SVC, 12 cycles. If we are taking STATCOM, it is increasing up to 17 to 18 cycles. Fault. This is fault clearing time in cycles. And this is approximately 25. This is highest one, right? But you see that whenever you are moving from this side to this side, cost is involved. What is happening with cost? If I'm taking a shunt compensator, it's although this data is old, but this is transformation may be there. So what will be there? A shunt capacitor is there. This value is in dollar per kVAr. I have taken this data from Verma Mathur, and this is $8 per kVAr. This is 20. This is 40 per kVAr. I'm talking about per kVAr over here, Statcom. Now you see that for a complete UPFC, 50 plus 50, that means this is one VSC and this is a complete combination. But I expect, I have not made the analysis. I find that there must be, this cost must be increased than this because coordination of two controllers are there. So this is justified at this moment, I can say. Now I'm taking a very small time for taking the machine dynamics. Because we are working with power system, as in the starting of the lecture I have told that we are working with power system. Power system means machines. Machines means synchronous machine. Then we are taking about three-phase induction machine. Then we are taking about permanent magnet synchronous machine. Then we can take single-phase induction machine. Now, you can see that if I want to replace all the machines, or if I want to understand all the machines by one concept, that can be done. How? I'm taking in all the machines, rotor is there, but obvious, stator is there, but obvious. So in all the machines, three windings on stator and three windings on rotor. That means whenever three windings or three systems or six systems are there, that means three plus three, six systems or six voltage equations will be there. Those are changing with respect to time. And in electrical terms, we used to say that if three windings are 120 degree displaced in time as well as space, the system is balanced. Whenever you remove one phase or two phases, the system will become unbalanced. So you can see in the previous slide, this is three-phase induction machine, rotor, we know very well, star connected, stator, this is again star connected, three-phase winding, three-phase winding. So on rotor as well as on stator, three windings are there, which are spaced in space and in time by 120 degree, the system will become balanced. So we can say that induction machine can be taken as a mother machine in dynamics. You come on to the synchronous machine. What is happening with synchronous machine? Armature winding is onto stator, three phase star connected, and we have earlier discussed that the system is balanced on stator. But on rotor, what is there? Only one winding is there, and that winding is your field winding. So the system will become unbalanced. Highly unbalanced case can be seen on to single phase induction machine. I think you have studied also. On stator, we have main winding and one auxiliary winding. That means one winding is there. And you see that you start the motor, you will not be able to start the motor. That is due to unbalancing on stator as well as on rotor. So this same concept can be implemented on synchronous machine. The same concept can be implemented onto the permanent magnet induction, permanent magnet synchronous machine, which is the latest machine in this particular area, machines area. So we have replaced only field winding with permanent magnet and nothing else. We can say that permanent magnet is equivalent to synchronous machine, but this field winding has been replaced with permanent magnet. So what can be concluded out of all this? This is mother branch, or this is mother machine. This is based upon the synchronous permanent magnet and single phase induction machine. These are based upon this machine. So once we are able to capture or understand the fundamentals of this machine, the same can be replicated onto synchronous, the same can be replicated onto this machine as well as onto this machine. So I'm trying to explain it with the help of phasors or windings in the next two or three slides. This is three-phase induction machine on rotor, three-phase stator winding on rotor, three-phase squirrel cage winding. Both are balanced. Then we have synchronous machine. Over here we have stator, we have rotor. This rotor is single phase, field winding system is balanced, this system is unbalanced. This is a permanent magnet synchronous machine, stator, rotor. I have replaced it with permanent magnet, so this system is unbalanced. This is main winding, so this is rotor balanced. The case has been reversed. And over here stator is there. Over here we have only one winding. Although we have two windings, it is only to start the system. Now the problem is, this synchronous machine is in three phase. If we are implementing Parks transformation, Parks transformation is converting these three phase system in two phase system. That means two windings, virtual windings, will be there on stator, which will be fixed. Two virtual windings will be there on the rotor, and these windings are virtually rotating with some speed, at what speed the motor is moving. Then you can say the interaction of these two fields is changing with respect to time. That effect can be seen on inductance. That means inductance on rotor as well as inductance on stator can be seen changing. So what will be there? That has to be there is a change in time. Time is theta is equal to omega t. So what will be there? Theta will change. If theta will change, the inductance will change. The problem remains same. The system will become complex. So we'll have to make one another transformation. I have not made the slide because this was out of the scope, and I'll have to make in a very hurry this particular part. So I can show it onto the picture also. I'll be telling the diagram first of all, and after that I'll be explaining that how it is working. So second transformation is D2, or you can say rotating DQ axis to stationary DQ axis. So once this is stationary, and that part can be taken onto one D axis and one Q axis. Then what we have to do, if you are taking the case of a transformer, we used to refer all the parameters from rotor to stator. So third transformation is we are transferring from rotor to stator. All the quantities has to be referred onto rotor to stator. And the fourth and the much required theory, that is called reference frame theory. Last is your reference frame theory. That is why I'm saying you the mother machine. So over here, if you're going back onto this slide, over here there can be three reference frame. One is rotor reference frame, another is stator reference frame, so, and third is synchronously rotating reference frame. So if all the quantities are rotating onto rotor reference frame, that means we'll have to choose rotor reference frame. If all the quantities are concerned with stator, then we'll have to say that stator reference frame has to be chosen. Now, in this case, you can see in this stator has, this rotor has unbalanced part. In permanent magnet, again, this is unbalanced on rotor. But in single phase induction machine, what is there? This rotor is there, and this is this stator is unbalanced. So whichsoever part is unbalanced, that reference frame has to be chosen by you. I'm repeating. If you are looking onto this bold and unbold part, the unbold part is unbalanced. If you look onto this machine, this system is unbalanced. If you look onto this machine, this part is unbalanced, as I have earlier explained. And this single phase induction machine, it is again unbalanced. So take this machine, convert it into synchronous permanent magnet or single phase induction machine. So these two parts are common or balanced. So for induction machine, you can choose any reference frame. You can apply a rotor reference frame. You can apply a synchronously rotating reference frame. You can apply a stator reference frame. But over here, you cannot apply stator reference frame because the system is unbalanced over here. So whichsoever thing is unbalanced, you will have to see that particular part. So you will have to do one exercise. Just move on to the FEC devices or motors and this analysis and make a small exercise onto this. Take 10 or 20 models of all the machines. Over there, you will be finding there is a dialog box. On dialog box, find out synchronous machine, all synchronous machine models. You will be finding that rotor reference frame has been chosen every time. When you are moving on to permanent magnet, you will be finding that all the models have rotor reference frame because it is unbalanced over there. And on single phase induction machine, again, this is rotor is balanced, but unbalanced is the stator part. So over here, stator reference frame has been chosen. Mind it. If you are taking synchronous machine in stator, all the values will be wrong. If you are taking permanent magnet, it will be a permanent magnet on rotor, that will be wrong. And if you are taking single phase induction machine on rotor reference frame or synchronously rotating reference frame, that scenario will be totally different. So my suggestion to all of you is, future scope is, you can take any system from MATLAB environment. There are a lot of systems in MATLAB environment in electrical machines part. You can take a synchronous machine and put it onto with FEC devices and change the reference frames and see the difference. Conclude the result. Although it is very well known that for this particular machine, rotor will be referred. For this particular machine, stator will be this rotor will be referred, or this stator will be referred. But you can make the analysis. Fine. So, what will be the effect of reference frame theory on complete power system? Whether it is a deregulated environment, whether it is a conventional power system, or whether it is a wind farm integrated power system. So, you can see the various scenarios. Coming out of the conventional part, that over here you can choose anyone, over there you can choose stator, then you can apply that stator. What is happening with that and why it is happening that? Over here you can do the same thing. So my suggestion is that number one, you can see the system with respect to rotor reference frame, and from controller point of view, you can add many controllers. I have taken only one controller, that is SSR. There are transient stability, there is small signal stability, lot of stability analysis is there. Now that can be implemented into deregulated environment, that can be implemented onto what we can say renewable energy sources, isolated wind, isolated plants, hybrid systems. So over there, what will be the scenario, all can be checked. Thank you very much. If you have any doubt, you can please ask.